Okay, before starting the session, I want to discuss about the basic thing related to what is project and what is product. What is project and what is product? Here, any idea what is this project and what is this product?
Yes, I mean, like a project means usually the software projects that Indian companies get, and product testing is like bigger companies usually like Samsung or Apple. They keep developing the products and
Not
they
exactly.
may carry out testing.
Sorry to interrupt you. Not exactly. I will give you the better clarity on that. Here, the project means if you are implementing anything in the point of a single customer, if any application if you are implementing for this single customer, say, that's nothing but project out here. That's nothing but product. Okay? Example I will tell you. Assume that whatever the application here, example. You are using some of the application in banks or otherwise some of the applications in the companies internally. Assume that if you go for any company, inside one internal applications will be there. Okay? Assume that. Okay, internal applications means like HR applications. Assume that they are using some HR applications. To maintain the human means employees' data, they are going to use some internal applications. That application. Okay, is that application can be accessible from outside of the particular company?
No.
No, right? Why we cannot capable means actually that is a software, that's one of the software application which was implemented by one of the company for the sake of the bank related HR activities, right?
Yes.
That means they have implemented for the sake of single company customer over there. For that company's sake, one of the software company has implemented that application to access their activities over there. That means
Yes.
sing for the sake of single customer they have implemented those type of things, we can call it as project. Those type of things we can call it as project only. That means here that customer is going to give the requirements to the company. Based upon his requirements, he is going to start implementation of the application. Nothing he means here company, the software company is going to implement that particular application over there.
Okay.
This means for a single customer sake, they are implementing that type of things. We can call it as project. Got it?
Okay.
Next, coming to the product. Coming to the product. Product means here, if you are implementing any application in the point of multiple customers, if you are implementing any application in the point of multiple customers, that's nothing but product. Example, Microsoft products. I can say you best example, Microsoft. Microsoft is releasing the products into the market, okay, for the sake of multiple users or otherwise a single user.
For multiple users.
That means they are creating that particular applications or any software for the sake of multiple users and they are releasing into the market. They are releasing into the market. Thus, things are nothing but products example. If you go for general life, the examples for the product is paste, water bottle, soaps. Okay, these are all the things they are manufacturing for the sake of multiple users. Those are product-based companies. Product-based
Yes.
companies and project-based companies are different. Okay, project-based, service-based, and product-based companies. Okay, coming to the project-based or service-based companies means you can see that TCS, Infosys. Okay, these are all the things will concern the service-based or project-based companies. Coming to the product-based, as I told you already, IBM is the best example for that. Sorry, Microsoft is the best example for that. IBM also product-based thing only. It is project and as well as product-based thing IBM. Okay, both the things it is having. Now, my understood. Do you have the clarity between what is project and product now?
Yes,
Any
understood.
questions up to now? Okay, I'm going speed. If you are saying that I'm going speed, I will get down the speed.
No, it's fine. You can carry on like this.
Okay. Now, my next question. If you go for project-based company, sorry, project-based things, single customer will be there. He is going to give the requirements. According to that requirements, you are going to implement the application. According to that requirements, you are going to implement the application. But coming to the product, okay, who is going to give you the requirements?
Like we design like the very way like how we want the product, we design it, and then with that is the requirements, like what we want to, the objective that we want to achieve by
yes,
creating.
If you want to sell the product in the market for a better thing, yeah. If your product want to exist in the market for a longer period, how you are going to do it? That requirements, how you are going to gather it and ask it?
I think by taking some feed, not feedback, but opinions from people who...
Is that practically possible to take each and every person's feedback and according based upon their feedbacks, is that possible to implement the application?
No.
It's not possible practically. But these things, okay, they are going to, one each and every product-based companies are going to maintain one of the requirements called R&D, research and development.
Okay.
Research and all.
Okay.
Assume that you want to create new e-commerce application and you want to release into the market. Templates, actually each and every e-commerce application, how many applications you are seeing in the market, they are available with the templates. Okay. If any customer is asking for any application related to the e-commerce, simply they are going to modify something in that and they are going to deliver it to the customer. If you go for the internet, means Google, or if you can search in that, you are going to get e-commerce templates. E-commerce
okay.
templates, you are going to get it. They are going to get that particular templates and simply they are going to modify that thing according to the customer requirements and they are going to submit to the customer at that point of time.
Okay.
Okay, that type of things will come under. Actually, if you want to create like that, assume that you want to create a new antivirus and you want to release into the market. Assume that
okay.
you want to create a new antivirus and you want to release into the market. At that point of time, okay, the particular R&D department people are going to do the research in the market. They are going to
okay.
research in the market. What are the existing antivirus are available? What that providing you the features? They are going to put all this information into one document. Apart from this, they are going to take a few end user feedback. Not all the things. They are going to take a few end user feedback. They are going to take a few end user feedback and they are going to add that points also to the particular existing document. Existing document. And then what will happen? They are going to send that particular document to the technical department of the company. Those people are going to finalize that which can be implementable, which cannot be implementable.
Okay.
They are going to finalize that which can be implementable, which cannot be implementable. Based upon that, they are going to implement the project over. Got it?
Yeah.
Now, do you have any questions up to now? Coming to the particular project and product basic things, what we discussed up to now?
No. No questions.
Okay. Now, coming to the R&D, is that the R&D department work is a single day work, or otherwise if it is a 1 year work or 2 years work, is there any limitation for the R&D people work?
No, R&D is a continuous process.
Why?
Because we need to keep developing the product and we need to do research on what that can be added. So it is a continuous process.
Why we have to do that? What is the reason behind it?
Because customers always want a better working products. So in order to do that, we need to keep designing and we need to keep developing the product so that it can stay in the market. So it is a continuous process.
Yes, exactly. The thing is, if your product want to exist in the market for a longer period. Definitely, you have to change your application related features according to the current market strategies. If you are not modifying the things according to your current marketing strategies, obviously your product or your application, no one is going to use at that point of time, right?
Yes.
Assume that if you go for a Windows operating system, not continuing with 10, right? Now it is running with 10. At the same point of time, is that going to stop with 10? It is not going to stop, right? According to the current marketing strategies, they are going to change the features and they are going to add new features and they are going to release into the market a new release. Or that means they have to change continuously according to the current marketing strategies, okay, to exist their product in the market consistently for a longer period. It's not a single day activity, it's a continuous activity.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the thing related to the product and project related. And one more question from my side. As you know that if you go for any, assume that Google database, okay, the database, they are going to maintain the database on different locations, right? On UK and in India, in Singapore, or in different locations, okay, in US.
Yeah.
Okay, like this different locations, they are going to maintain the servers. Why they are maintaining the servers on different locations? Why they are not maintaining at one location?
I'm not really sure about that, but one reason that I think is that they need to duplicate the data in order to avoid data failure, like in case of a data loss. And apart from that, I'm not really sure why they do.
Okay, then. Here, okay, I will tell you the thing. Actually, the thing is, whatever the recovering, taking backup, maintaining different data, different servers means, to maintain the things, okay, means if one server is getting down, okay, to use the particular things. They are going to, if it is one server is getting down, simply they are going to up another server which is available in another location. But my question, if you are, why they are not maintaining at one location means, I think you know that natural calamities like earthquake,
yes,
like these type of things will come into the picture. If all the servers at one place, what is the use of taking a backup? Obviously, yes, all the things will get crashed. Then again, you have to start from the scratch. If that thing, if you are maintaining in different weather locations, it is not possible to get all in all the location at a single point of second. In all the location at a single point of second, it won't get any natural calamities, right? In all the locations. Maybe in US something happened, the server has getting crashed. In India it will be there. Okay? Something, if in UK or Singapore something has happened, then UK server will be there. Okay, like this, they are having one alternative every time. Okay, without going for the scratch again. Means if you are implementing scratch also, the lot of data will be get lost over there. That data cannot be recoverable if you are maintaining that. Maybe the application you can implement from the scratch again, we don't have any problem with that. With the good features, rather than the previous application, with a better application you can implement. But that, what about data? Is that can be recoverable? If it is getting crashed, all the things?
No.
It's not right. That's why they are going to maintain all the servers in a different locations over there and different weather conditions.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, assume that once the project has come into the picture, once the project has came into the picture to the company, after that, how they are going to implement it, the particular application development?
The product will initially, like I'm not aware of the complete cycle of software SDLC.
Mm-hmm.
Like I've gone through it some time back. But the thing is that first they do the development of the project. They gather the requirements and what are the resources that are required, both technical and material. And after developing the product, they'll carry out the testing, and in some cases they carry out the testing simultaneously along with the development. This is the idea that I have.
Okay, no problem. Okay, means here the phases I'm giving you the clarification first gathering requirements. Here, gathering requirements means, you know that they are going to, the BA, business analyst, is going to gather the requirements from the customer. Okay, he's going to gather the requirements. After gathering the requirements, okay, what they are going to do?
After gathering the requirements, the business analyst will explain it to the development team. I mean, explain means he will prepare a document wherein he will list out the how to carry out the development.
Okay, before that some process will be there. Okay. Here the BA is after gathering the requirement is going to prepare the particular BRS, business requirement specification.
Okay.
They are going to prepare the business requirement specification. Here next, after gathering the requirements, they will go for planning. Okay, without having prior plan, is that possible to complete the project within the time or within the budget? Is that possible?
No.
It's not possible, right? It's not possible, okay, to complete the project within the time and within the budget. At that point of time, they are going to, okay, prepare two types of plans, which is nothing but project plan and test plan.
Okay,
here project plan means it is going to carry out by the project manager or team manager or otherwise team leader, okay, based upon the situation. Okay, they are going to prepare. Mostly the project plan will be prepared by the project manager and the team test plan will be prepared by the team leader. Okay, for a project is a overall plan for the total project implementation. Coming to the test plan, it's specifically designed for the sake of testers. For that application, how we are going to carry out the testing, they are defining the process over. They are defining the process over. Right?
Okay.
This is the thing related to plan. After the planning, they will go for design. Okay? What is this design? Design means, as you know that the BRS contains the raw requirements of the customer, it cannot be understandable by any person actually. In a proper way, nobody can understand this particular BRS. They are going to further divide that particular BRS into, okay, some understandable documents actually. Okay, means for the developers actually, the LLD document is the perfect document to understand the activities of a particular customer requirements. That's what they are going to divide this particular document into HLD and LLD. High level design and low level design over here. Okay, high level design, okay, and the low level design. Actually, they are going to carry out this document preparation by using some diagrammatical representations. Who is going to prepare this means? System architect or system analyst under the guidance of BA. Okay, now LLD contains, means which type of diagram means? ERD, entity relationship diagrams. HLD means they are going to develop the document by using some DFDs, data flow diagrams. But these are the things they are going to prepare by the, means the people, a system analyst is going to prepare that particular document. After preparing that, okay, they are going to send it to the development department to develop this. This LLD document is the perfect document for the developer to implement the functionalities or to go for the coding part. You can see now, next phase is coding mode. In this coding, who is going to do this coding? Developers. Developers will do the coding mode.
Yes.
While they are developing the code, two times they are going to carry out the testing. Okay, what are those things means? Assume that if you go for the any application, functionalities will be there. Okay, if you go for a small application like if you go for the particular Gmail login or a Gmail project, assume that Gmail a project. Under that, a single developer is not going to develop all the functionalities, right? If single developer is developing also, is going to develop functionality by functionality. Not at one shot, he is going to write the total code, right? Assume that the login is going to write one and compose mail and receiving mail. Like this, different functionalities will be there. For each and everything, individually is going to implement one program. Okay, they are going to divide the project into functionalities and they are going to distribute it to the developer to implement the project. At this point of time, whatever the work they have divided, each and every developer is going to carry out a small functionality implementation. okay, that each and every functionality after implementation by them, they are going to cross check with themselves, is that working fine or not. With themselves, after implementing by the developer one time, whatever the functionality they have assigned to, they will check one time with them whether it is working fine or not according to the customer requirements or according to the documents. If it is working fine, they will send it to the next levels. Otherwise, they are going to modify the code. Again, they are going to check it. That type of thing, we are going to call it as unit testing, a small component testing. Okay?
Okay.
That unit testing will be carried out by whom?
By the developers itself, right?
Developers, perfect. Now, once that implementation is completed, then they will go for integration. That is nothing but they are going to integrate all the small units at one place and they are going to test it one more time. That is nothing but integration testing.
Okay. So integration testing is also carried out by the developers?
Developers. But okay, depends upon the experience.
Okay.
Here, two times the developer is carrying out the testing. The particular unit testing and as well as integration testing. Then what is the use of testers again? Developer is doing two times testing here, then what is the use of testers for here? What is the use of testing department?
Well, like other aspects of testing, like user acceptance and authentication and authorization. Hello?
Yeah, is that can be not means done by the developers. They did all the things, right? First, individually, they have checked it out. And after completion of that, they have gone through the particular integration part. Okay? They are going to check it one more time. Okay? Then is that testing is not sufficed by them? What they did?
I'm not sure, actually. I don't know, like, why they do that.
I will tell you. Here, the thing why they are going to carry out this type of thing, again, why the testers are requirements. Assume that if you are creator of something, is your brain is going to accept to identify the mistakes in your creativity?
No.
Obviously no, right? It's a general human tendency. And obviously, while you are creating something, you are going to use your 100% brain and you are going to check it out. This is the thing like this, you are going to check it out and you are going to give the thing from your side 100%, right? Then, but yeah, if any third party person, if it is verifying your work, what will happen? If any third party person is verifying your work, is going to cross check and is going to tell some modifications to your existing work, right? That means here you did a mistake, just do like this, okay? It is better, it has to be like this. Like this is going to give some more instructions. That means you've already used your 100% brain and you have implemented something. Your brain not in a position to think outside that boundaries.
Yeah.
Okay? The same thing if the third party person is verifying that, then he is in a position to give you some instructions or modifications on that. To put that in a right path. Okay, like that only, coming to the development, the developers are the creators only. They are creating something there by using their own creativity. Assume that if they are implementing Gmail login functionality, okay, what they will do, they are, after implementation of that, is going to give valid username and password and is going to check that whether the inbox page is displaying or not. Up to that only they are going to check it, they won't check more than that.
Okay.
Okay, that means that is called positive testing. They are going to check like that and they are going to send it to the next levels of things. As a tester, how he is going to check it means he is going to check in a different ways, like valid username, invalid password, invalid username, valid password, invalid username, invalid password. If you are checking like this, it should not display the inbox page, right?
Yes.
If it is displaying the inbox page at that point of time,
then it is not working for.
It's a defect, right? It's a mistake.
Yeah.
Okay, if the same mistake, assume that the end user has found before finding the developers. Testing is not there, assume that. The developers did that and they send it to the client. The client found that mistake.
Yeah.
The client found that mistake. At that point of time, it becomes failure. If it fails to resolve that, it is going to take much more budget and much more time.
Yeah.
Okay. That means those type of things actually, okay, they will get, it will get down the customer business as well as it will get down the software company brand also. Company brand will be get down as well as the customer image also will get down in the market. Okay.
Yeah.
At this point of time, those things will not be recoverable things. Recoverable things. Okay. That's what if the testing department is there, if third party person is there in the company itself to check whether you did the work in a proper way or not, then chances of getting mistakes at the end will be very less, right?
Yes.
Is the testers part what is means? Before finding the mistakes by the developer, say end user, nothing but a client, okay, the tester in your company is going to identify that and they are going to show it to the developers, okay, whether it is working fine.
Yeah.
Okay, if it is having anything, they are going to show it to the developer. Developer has to rectify it. Then again, testers has to test it whether it is working fine or not.
Yeah.
Okay, that is the testers part. Here, testers are customer representatives. You have to put your legs into the shoes of the customer every time. Sorry. You have to put your legs into the shoes of the customer every time, and you have to think in the mind of customer, and you have to test the application.
Okay.
Here, developer required more technical knowledge, tester required more domain knowledge.
Oh, yes.
Developer required more technical knowledge and a tester required more domain knowledge. There's a part related to why the testing team, why the testers are requirements. This is the reason why the testers are required for a company. Okay, this is the thing related to testing. Testers, who is going to do the testing means they are going to carry out the testing called system testing.
Yeah.
System testing. If it is successfully executed, then they will send that particular application to the next levels. There is nothing bad. Delivery and maintenance. Who is going to do this means? Production team. Okay, production team will carry out this particular delivery and maintenance. In this case, they are going to deliver the application to the client, and that maintenance is where they are going to support for the maintenance parts. This is a thing related to the particular SDLC or software development also. Got it?
Yeah.
These are the things related to the SDLC part, quantum charge phases. Okay. Now, actually, what is testing? What's the general discussion? Yeah. Testing. What's the definition of the testing part?
So like basically testing means to check whether the project or product is working according to the client requirements.
Exactly. You said the statement in a perfect manner. Checking whether the developed application is working according to the customer requirements or not. Is nothing but testing. It's a traditional definition. That means nothing but previous based definition is this. Say previous based definition. Okay, now the definition has redefined, we'll discuss about that later. Okay, here is a traditional definition over there. Okay, anyway, this is the thing first we are going to discuss, then we'll go for the next nowadays definition. Coming to this, checking whether the developed application is working as per the customer requirements or not. That means after developing the application, okay, you are going to test on the particular front-end application. You are not going to see any source code over there. Here, the developers are going to do two times testing, unit testing and integration testing. If both are successfully executed, they are going to convert that application into an executable file. Assume that an example for that, you are installing some software in your system. For that, you require some setup file, right? You are going to double click on .exe, nothing but a setup file, and you are going to install that software into your system. Is that right or not?
Yes.
That .exe file which you are seeing over there, inside that, n number of lines of code will be there. Is that able to, are you able to see that? Is that displaying over there? It's not going to display over there, right? At that point of time, the developers did the development. Once it is, if they are confirming that if it is working fine, then they have converted into the particular .exe file. Nothing but building. They are going to build that particular project. They are going to convert that particular total source code into an executable file, and they are going to send it to the testing department to test it.
Yeah.
Okay. Testers are not going to see any source code, just they are going to see the front-end application and they are going to carry out the test. For the testers not required any technical knowledge over here for manual testing. Okay, they are going to see the front-end application and they are going to test it. This is the thing, how we are going to carry out the testing. If that application, if it is developed by Java or PHP or some .NET, some other language by that, if it is developing, is there any change will come into the picture in manual testing? Is the testing depends upon the technology? Is related to application development related technology?
No, I don't think it is related to the technology.
No, it is not related to the thing, how you have implemented. An implemented thing you are doing, you are performing some actions over there. According to the customer requirements, is that working or not? I don't require on which technology and based upon which language you have implemented the application.
Yes.
Just I require that whether the application is working, developed application is working according to the customer requirements or not. That's matter to me as a tester.
Yeah.
Okay, you have to think in that way and you have to test it. You should not keep in your mind which technology they have used, how they have implemented, how they have written the code. In that things, in that way, you no need to check it. You no need to think it. Okay, you have to check whether the developer thing is working according to the customer requirements or not. That's the part you have to do as a tester.
Yeah.
That's a tester. What is the major objectives of testing?
I'm sorry?
What are the major objectives of testing?
Objectives of testing, like carrying out not only like front end but also like there are if it is correctly being
translated to the back end. Whatever testing types you are applying, that's a different part. Why you are doing that? Why we have to go for that? There's a thing is the major objective is for that to deliver a quality product to the customer.
Okay.
What is quality? In which way you can define the quality?
Trying to match what the requirements need.
That means if customer is satisfied with your work or with your service, then the application having obviously the quality, right? The application is having quality, then only the customer is going to satisfy with the thing. If he is satisfaction, we can say it as quality is nothing but in simple words, customer satisfaction.
Yeah.
Okay. You can define in a simple words. If the customer is satisfied with your service or with your application development, at that point of time, that's nothing but a quality product or quality things.
Yeah.
Okay. And the second major objective is to find the bugs in that particular application. Bugs or defects, whatever. Okay. To find the bug settings. The major objectives of testing. Got it? Any questions on this?
No. I understood.
Okay. Coming to the testing, you have manual testing and automation testing. What is this manual testing?
Manual testing. Like automation testing means we carry it on a large scale. I mean, like to like how many number of users use the application at the same time, and whether it is working or not. Manual testing is the process. It requires the tester. I mean, like to check like say suppose like a game testing. If you are checking a game. So like only a single user game, whether it is functioning or not, like that.
Okay, then I will give you the clarity. In automation also, you are going to do the same checking, right? Okay, I will give you the clarity.
Yes.
Here, manual testing means simply, just as the name it is indicating, manual testing. That means if you are carrying out any testing activity by a human, if you are carrying out testing activity by a human, okay? Example, the simple thing, in manual testing, only two things will be available, human and the application.
Okay.
Human and the application. You are going to interact with the application directly and you are going to carry out some testing process to check that whether the functionality is working properly or not. That's nothing but manual testing. AUT means application under test. If you are interacting with the application directly, okay, there is nothing but manual testing. Now coming to the automation, in between you and the application, one tool will be there.
Okay.
And you are going to instruct the tool by using some scripting language, okay, to automate that particular manual activity.
Yeah.
Okay. That means, that's nothing but here, how it is doing means, this is a process how you are going to carry out the automation. That means, what is automation testing means? If you are carrying out any testing activity through a tool, that's nothing but automation. That's nothing but automation testing.
Without a tool, if you do the testing, it is manual.
If a human is interacting with the application directly, and if he is carrying out any testing activity over there, that's nothing but manual testing. And if you are carrying out the same thing with a tool, that's nothing but automation testing. What is the general meaning of automation? Without human interaction, you are performing some automated activities over here. Example, I will tell you why we have to go for automation. The small example I will give you with a general like example. Assume that a family contains two members. At this point of time, that family contains two members. Okay, they used to drink coffee two times a day. Then, is there any requirement to buy a coffee machine over there?
No.
It's not required, right? Okay, then coming to the family, now assume that family contains 20 members. They used to drink coffee five times a day.
Okay.
Then is that required?
Yeah.
That's required. Why means here the number of people has increased, the number of iterations means number of times of making coffee is getting increased. At this point of time, if you will go with automation, it will be useful at that point of time. That is nothing but what you are automating over there. You are automating the activity of making coffee.
Yeah.
Okay, that means that machine is doing that activity, okay, automating that making coffee only. There's nothing bad here, okay, automation, why you have to go for means. If the application is, okay, having regression cycles are long and iterative. Okay, you won't understand now. Okay, we will see that thing later. Okay, regression cycles are long and iterative means, assume that, okay, if it is a big size application, we are going to test it repeatedly, right? For each and everything, you are going to do the, repeatedly you are going to test the same functionalities n number of times. Before releasing any application into the market, internally n number of releases will be there. In a single time, nobody can capable of implementing the applications or products. It's not possible to anyone. Okay, as a human, everybody is going to do the mistakes. Okay, at a single point of time or in a single shot, it's not possible to get the perfect outcome. any company can capable of delivering a risk-free product to the customer, but they cannot capable of delivering a defect-free product to the customer. Any company, not only a single company. If you go for any company, no company can capable of delivering a defect-free application to the customer or error-free application to the customer. They can capable of only delivering the risk-free product to the customer according to the customer requirements.
Like, what is the basic difference between like risk-free and
risk-free? Example, if you go for ATM application,
yeah,
okay, if you go for ATM application, what is the major functionality of the ATM application?
To give the balance, to give money,
to withdrawal is the major factor, and apart from the transaction history, and if possible, card to card transfer. These are the major functionalities of the particular ATM application.
Yeah.
At this point of time, assume that you have an option, I think you know or don't know, okay? The option, you can recharge your mobile, nothing but your 2G or the prepaid account by using the ATM card in ATM machine. Do you know that?
Yeah. Yes.
Recharge. You can recharge your prepaid account through the ATM machine itself. Through the ATM software itself, you can do it. But many people don't know that. Okay, assume that if that application or if that functionality, if it is not working under the ATM application, is that going to get affected on the customer business?
Yes.
That is not going to affect on the customer business, right? Why? Because most of the people don't know that. If they know also, how many people are going to recharge through the ATM application only?
Okay. Yeah, not many people know that.
Means many people don't know, and as well as if they know also, they won't go for them online recharge, or otherwise they are going to recharge the mobile, okay, from the particular shops. Like that, they are going to do the things. They won't prefer most of the times that particular ATM related thing. Okay, like that.
Yeah.
If something is not working, okay, if it is not going to affect on that, at that point of time, they won't concentrate more on the particular recharge thing. They are going to concentrate more on the particular withdrawal and all those things. If withdrawal is not happening, or if the card to card transfer is not happening, or if the particular transaction history is not getting, at that point of time, okay, they have to they have to resolve that issues on priority basis. Is that right or not?
Yes, that is most priority.
Most priorities. There is nothing but like that. If means they are capable of delivering the application if the recharge functionality is not going to work. But if the particular card to card transfer, or as well, if the withdrawal functionality, if it is not working, is they are going to deliver the application to the client?
No, they cannot, because it is very crucial.
Okay, like this, the thing is, okay, based upon the priority levels, they are going to test it and they are going to send it. That is nothing but a risk based one, right?
Yeah.
Okay. One more example, I will tell you why the risk based over here. If you go for a functionality,
yes.
I am giving you one text box over here. Is that possible to test this text box? Is that possible to test this text box? Okay. How many ways you can capable of testing this text box? May I know that?
Like by opening it and trying to enter some textual data. And checking whether it is accepting the input and it is showing correctly, or if there are any changes.
Without having the requirements, is that the right way to test it?
No, we need to have the requirements, like what is the customer expecting from the text box.
Yes, first you have to know the customer requirements, then only you can capable of doing testing. Without having customer requirements, without having proper conditions, you should not go for the testing. It's a waste of time, it's a waste of budget over there.
Yeah.
If without knowing the customer expectations, how you are going to test any functionality? You cannot capable. You should not do it. Okay, if you are doing also, it's a waste of time, because your assumption will not take into the matter. Okay, what is the customer required? That is the matter over there.
Yes.
Okay. That's what they have to first, they have to give some things over there. Example, I am giving you the requirements. it should accept single characters.
Okay.
And it has to accept either uppercase or lowercase letter. Okay. And it's a mandatory field. Now, can you tell me how many ways you can check it?
It should take basically characters. So, and so if we like, it is mandatory field. So, if we do not fill it and we click on OK or submit button,
okay,
it should throw an error.
Okay, in a format or in a sequence, I will tell you. You can check with first A, B, capital A, B, C, like this capital J. Okay, next, small a, B, C, D, like this, you are going to check Z. With these, all the things will come under value. Coming to the invalid, you are going to check with blank. If you are giving blank, it should not accept it, right? Then you can give the numerics and you can give the special characters. These all the things will come under invalid data. And you are going to give more than one character. If you are trying to combinations, if you are giving more than one character, you should not accept. Okay? Yes. Like this, if you are testing like this with each and every possibility, how much time it is going to take? Is there any ending for this if you are doing testing like this?
It will take a lot of time.
Okay, for a single text box, you are taking this much time. In a project, okay, for a single page, how many elements will be there like this? For a single for a module, how many pages will be there? For a project, how many modules will be there? Okay, is that possible to complete the project within the time, within the budget?
No.
That's why, if you are testing like this, I'm not denying you are going to get a perfect application at the end. But with how much budget, with how much time, is there any requirement to do like that? If you are getting like the perfect application also, is there any need with that perfect application? What they are going to do?
No.
Okay, that's what testing like this is not possible. If you are testing is not actually a limited period activity, it's a continuous activity. It's a continuous activity. Okay, now while you are doing this particular part, it's not possible to test like this. Okay, that's what they are going to check. By covering all the functionalities, by covering all the possibilities, they are going to decrease n number of test cases and they are going to test it. At that point of time, okay, we are not going to test with each and everything. There's nothing but it's a risk-based thing only, right? If you're missing or if you're skipping something means, obviously it is making you some risk over there. Assume that.
Yes.
Now, you have tested under this particular thing with some M. You entered capital M and you have checked it out, whether it is working fine or not, and you have gone through the next level, next section of data. At this point of time, you are skipping all the things other than the M over here. Is there a risk or not? There is a chances. If you are not checking with A, there is a chances while you are giving capital A, is that going to work or not? We cannot expect it, right?
Yeah.
Okay, there is a chance. We cannot skip each and everything. But if you are skipping and you are testing because of the time limitation and budget limitation, at that point of time, there is a chance of getting the defect where you left it. Something you left it, right, to test it. In that area itself, there is a chance of getting the particular problems. At that point of time, we cannot check with each and every possibility. That's what we can capable of delivering a risk-free product to the customer. We cannot capable of delivering defect-free product or error-free product to the customer. It's not possible to deliver. Perfect application or perfect things are not possible.
Okay.
This is what I tell you. Okay, why the particular testing is we can capable of delivering the risk-free product to the customer to give you better thing in that. There's nothing but without disturbing their customer business, you have to deliver the application in that.
Okay.
Got it? Any questions?
Yeah, no questions.